Just over a year ago, Australian winger Digby Ioane was preparing to face the Lions in Brisbane. But then his career headed in a new direction when he decided to leave Australia for the glamour of life in Paris with Stade Français.
Most people come when they retire. For me, it's not like I got dropped or anything. I've achieved a lot with the Reds, and I think it was just time just to explore what's out there. And like, you know, I just turned 29 this year, and I just want to, you know, what else is there, you know, other than just staying in Australia, just to explore the world and just travel and play. So for me, it's a whole new thing to me, but you get to find yourself, you know, at the same time, you learn a lot about yourself.
But the move has proved far from easy.
I found it hard to just to get to know my teammates, because most of them don't really speak English. You know, I don't blame them, because I'm the one coming to Paris to play with them. So for me, it's the language that gets me, but you get used to it. Like last year when I got here, I came halfway through the season, and I found it, you know, so hard to communicate with them. But now I've been here for almost a year, and I did a full pre-season with my teammates, and just used to it now. So a bit of broken English, but I still understand them. So, and I try my best to try and speak French, but it's not the best. But all my teammates, you know, all friendly, and we do have a lot of foreigner players, like South Africans. We've got a couple of islanders like Fijians and Samoans. But the team spirit is pretty good.
Away from the pitch, there are different problems.
I miss my family heaps. Like, it's good to have that support when you... I just miss, like, going to games, and you always got your brother or your sister, or especially your mum and dad, just on the stand. That just gives me an extra motivation. But to be over here and have no one, that's just... It's a bit sad, but then again, you're here for a reason, and that's to play good footy for Paris.
But the Melbourne-raised winger received some much-needed support when his nephew Monty joined him in Paris.
It's helped me a lot, I guess. It's good to have, you know, your nephew around. It makes you feel like you're still in Australia, but it's just me and him at the moment. I think if I came by myself, I think I would have struggled big time. But it's just good to have someone, you know, with you and have that... that relationship with her in a company and stuff, you know, to clean your clothes and stuff. And he doesn't know how to cook. I can't cook myself, but it's just good to have him around. So I'm not the only one, you know, in Paris.
One thing I know about Digby is that he gets really homesick really easy. And but he's told me many times, like, he's so happy to have me here because he does really start to miss home. And he said to me, if I wasn't here, he probably would have cried and went back straight away in the first week or something. But actually, if he wasn't here, I probably wouldn't even be here where I am at the moment. But I think I've you know, helped him heaps with his homesickness and whatnot.
Now more settled, Ioane is thriving in a team packed with international stars.
All these experienced players that you never thought you would play with, every time you play against them, they're like the enemies. Now you're like best mates, like Mone Stein, he's like my enemy, and I'm like his best mate. So it's really weird when you get to play with all those mixed players. I think that's something special, you know, to be part of. Like, I'm just a kid that's came from Australia. I was living in that small bubble. And then you don't realise the next minute you're playing with all these international experienced players. And for me to play with them, I think that's, it's something special to me, because I never thought I'd be playing with these guys, but they're very humble and, you know, really friendly.